So today we are discussing the file handling, and under that we are discussing the defining and opening the file. So how we are going to define the file and how we are going to open for the working, that we will learn today. First of all, I am giving you the syntax of the file. Then afterward, we will learn what are the things required one by one. So first of all, there is a file. Now, what that file is? This file is the data type or the data structure provided to us. So we can say that it is the data type which is already available. So this is the data type we are going to use in the file handling. Data type is the part of data structure. As we are having integer, float, character as a data type, similarly the file is the data type available to us in the input-output library of the C programming. Now for the file data type, we are going to create one object or the pointer. Now we are saying file star fp. Just like if I give you one example, if I have to create one integer pointer, we say that int star a. So now we can say that a is the integer pointer. Similarly, fp is the file pointer. So here we can say that fp is the file pointer. We can say it, fp is the file pointer. There are something which are defined already into the system, which are inbuilt, like we have to create the first of all the file pointer. Now afterward, with the help of this file pointer, we can perform all the operation, like opening the file, closing the file, reading the file and writing the file. So this is how we are going to define the file. Now to open the file, we will use this file pointer, and I'm telling you the syntax. We will say the file pointer fp is equal to, the function given for opening the file is fopen. So fopen is the function that we are going to use for opening the file. In the bracket, in double quotes, we will give the file name. Whatever the file name you want to give, you can provide. Let us suppose that your file is demo.txt. So that file name you will provide. Comma mode. We will provide the mode. Now what that mode is, I will tell you. While we are opening the file, there are different modes available. With the help of the mode, we are going to work with the file. If I talk about the mode, now there are various modes which are available. Just like there is the R, W, A. So these are the three modes available. Now, if I say that XYZ is the file and I am passing mode as R. R means I want to read the file only. Means the file will open for reading purpose. We cannot modify it. We cannot add some data. W. If I am passing the W, that means file is open for writing purpose only. Means a new file is there and I have to write it. A, that is called append. Append is the mode which is called the update. Let us suppose that one file is created into the system, and in that file there is something is written. Now I want to add on the data after that previous data, then A is the append. Well, all these modes I will discuss in detail, but first of all I am explaining this particular line to you. Now talking about the file name. Now file name can be any file which you want to create or open. If the file is available into the system, so that file will open. Otherwise, if you are having the new file name, so that will be created. Let us suppose that we are giving some file name. Let us suppose demo dot txt. So any file name we can provide. Talking about fopen is the function. So there are so many functions which are available in the file handling, just like fopen, fclose, fseek. So various functions are there. We will discuss the functions one by one later on. But first we are discussing how to open the file. So now we are going to discuss the different modes which are available in the file handling. We know that these are the modes just like read, write and append. So first of all, we are discussing the read mode. So R is the read mode. If I am using R, that means I am opening the file for reading purpose. So this is the reading mode. Now, what are the things into the reading mode? What will happen? Let us suppose the file is there or file is not present. So what will happen? We are going to learn now. Assuming that you have opened the command for the file opening, you have passed some file name and you have passed the R, means the reading mode. Assume file not there. If file not exists, means you are saying that the file is demo.txt and that demo.txt file is not there into the system. What will happen? Now, in that case, you are going to read a file which is not available into the system. How can we read a file which is not there into the system? So there will be the error message. So error will occur. Remember one thing, all modes are different. So if I talk about, if I am opening the file in reading mode, then that means I am assuming that file is already there and I want to read that. So file not exist means error message will display. But yes, if file exists, what will happen? If the demo.txt file exists into the system, in that case, it will open the file with current content. So it will open file with current content. Current content means whatever the content it is available inside that, it will open it for the reading purpose. Now you can read that file. So these are the two different cases of the read mode. Now we are discussing the next case, that is the write mode. So we use W for the write. Now let us suppose that you are using the same syntax, file open, demo.txt is the file, and here you are passing W, means you are going to write that file. Again, there are two cases. Case number one, you have opened the demo.txt file, but that file not exist. So if this file not exists into the system, what will happen? Obviously, you have opened for the writing mode, means you want to write a file. If you want to write a file and file not exists, no problem. The file will be created. So file will be created and you can write onto that particular file. But assume that file already exists. You are going to open a file in writing mode and file already exists and some data is present. Now we are not going to append the data. We are going to write the data. Appending means modify. But here we are saying writing. Writing means writing from the scratch, from the start. So here, open the file, but content will be deleted. So here it will open file with content deleted. Means the file content is deleted. Now the file is fresh. You can work on it. Now the next mode we are having is the append mode. So now we are having the mode which is A. A means the append. Append we say that is the modify. Modify means the previous content is there and we want to add on. Now again in the append mode there are two cases. Let us suppose the file not exist. Assume that you are going to open a file to append it. Means previous there is something and you want to add on something. But file not exist. What will happen? It will create a file. So file is created. Now you can write inside that. But assume that file already exists. Now there is no problem. It will open the file with current content. Now here you can add on the content. Now with the help of diagram, I am explaining all the modes one by one to make you understand more. Let us suppose that this is my C program. Now with the help of this program, I want to create or add or modify the file inside the hard disk, secondary memory. This is the hard disk or secondary memory where I want to create a file. Now, we are going to take all the examples one by one. So this is the coding, C coding, and with the help of the code, I want to modify the file here in the secondary memory. So whatever the code we have learned, just like F open pointer, so everything we will write here in the C programming. And files will be modified into the secondary memory. Now, first of all, I am taking the example of writing. Assume that you are here into the C programming and you want to write a file. In your mind is there, I am creating a new file and I want to write it. That means your mind is saying a writing mode. And you assume that file is not there. So if file is not there, file will be created. Now here you are writing a code for writing a file. Now the file is not there into the secondary memory, so one file will be simply created. Let us suppose the file name I am assuming is demo.txt, so one file is created. The name of file is demo. Later on, say example, I am also coming on your system. In my mind, I also have the same concept that I want to create a file with the name demo. But I am not aware that already one file is present. I run the same command, file open, and with the file, I am putting the name and W. W means I want to write a file. But file already exists. What will happen? Maybe you have written something inside that. So once I will create the file again, so this file will open, but the earlier content will be deleted. So this earlier content will be deleted. I will be having the fresh file. Because the concept is clear. Concept is that we are going to write the file. Now, writing the file means I will be having the file fresh for writing. It is not appending to modify the file. It is for writing the file. So if the file is already there into the system, all the content of the file will be deleted and file will be given to you fresh. Or if file is not there, then file will be created. So that is the first case we have discussed, that is to write. In the write case, write means you assume that we want the fresh file. So this is a keyword. If file exists, it will delete and give you the fresh. If file is not there, it will create the fresh. Now the next mode in the mind is read. Let us suppose that after 2-3 days, I am coming to the system, to your system, and I want to read the file. Reading the file means in my mind the concept is clear. There will be some file and that file I have to read. Assume that now the file I am assuming is XYZ. Okay. So if I am coming on your system and I am writing a read operation, and if the file exists, let us suppose the file name I am assuming now is XYZ, and here I want to apply the read operation. I just come, I say fopen XYZ into the read mode. File exists, no problem. So if file exists in your system and I want to read that, no problem. System will open it with the current content. Means whatever is inside that, I can read it. But assume the file I want to open XYZ in the reading mode, that is not available. Let us assume it is not there into your system. So it is an error because the concept is clear. I want to read something from the file, but if file is not there, compiler will say error. You want to read something which is not present. That's where error occur. So the second case we have discussed is the reading file. A reading file is the simple. If file present, it will open you for read. If file not there, it will show you the error. Third case is the append. Append means modify. Now, in the modify, the concept is clear that there is certain file in the system and I want to write it. Write at the end. If some content is present in the file, that content will remain same. I want to add on. Assuming this time I am taking a file ABC. I am coming in your system to append the file. Append means modify the file. If file exists into the system, no problem. It will open the file with the current content for the modification. If ABC file is present and data is there, it will open it and I can modify. But assume that the file is not there. Append means writing. The same case of writing will work. In the writing case was, if file not exists, file will be created. Append is also writing, but writing at the end. You assume that there is nothing inside the file and the file is not there. So what will happen? If ABC is not there, so if file not exist, the file will be created. So these are the three modes, which are read, write and append, and all modes are logical. With the help of the logical examples, we can learn these modes, and with the help of this diagram, I have explained you about the different modes. So one more thing I want to explain. Let us suppose that I want to open two files together. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. See how. If I want to open two files in different modes, that is totally possible. We know one thing. One file means one pointer. So if I have to deal with two file, then we will say, first of all, file. We know that file is a data type. Then we are creating two pointers, star fp1 for the file one and star fp2 for the second file. Now we are saying fp1, which is file pointer one, is equal to file open. We are going to open the file. Well, for reading, writing and appending, the same command is going to apply, fopen. Let us suppose that the file name is data. data.txt assuming. And I want to open it into the read mode. So I will say R. So this data.txt will open into the reading mode. Assuming that I want to open one more file, file pointer 2, fopen. And that file I want to open into the write mode. Assume that the file name is result.txt. So that is the name of file, comma, we are saying is the writing mode. So we will pass W. So this way we are going to open the two files. One is data.txt into the reading mode and one is result.txt into the writing mode. We can also open n number of files depend upon the requirement. So that is all about defining and opening the file. And afterward, we are now going to discuss how to close the file.